Made in Sweden, so this corporate animal logo sweater was designed by Carl Grandin, and Bas was the model. Meanwhile, in the Ruhrgebiet.
A male wire condenser fancies a female. By rattling his wires, he persuades the female to follow him. The male leads the way, and she follows. Under the protection of a curled leaf, they will mate.
Bombarded with newspaper articles about biotech and genetic futures. It's a totally fascinating space, but it seems so far away from the world of design. Is this the debate that designers can participate in? How might these technologies actually really affect us in our everyday lives? We came across this wonderful report in the 70s that was written about public opinion. It said apparently that when we debate these issues, we debate in a very philosophical way. We act very responsibly as citizens, and we have these very, very clearly defined opinions. We think, yes, this is right, and no, this is wrong. But then we get off our soapboxes, and then we go shopping. And we buy things that totally contradict everything that 2 minutes ago that we've just said that we kind of believe in. It turns out that we behave very different to how we believe. So we want to move this debate away from one of the kind of philosophical and the citizen to one of the consumer. I want to reevaluate these technologies in terms of purchasable products.